Let's get into today's top stories. And it's been a huge 24 hours, the first of them for our new Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese. He's held bilateral talks with US President Joe Biden this afternoon on the sidelines of the Quad Summit in Tokyo.
We were sworn in, got in the plane, and if you fall asleep while you're here, it's okay. Because I don't know how you're doing it, but...
Earlier, he reaffirmed Australia's commitment to the Quad group with a renewed focus on climate change.
Climate change is not just about the environment, it's about the shape of our economies, but also our national security going forward.
And while Labor's win appears to have softened China's feelings towards Australia, Beijing has put the US on notice. It's warned the Americans they're playing with fire after the US president promised to come to Taiwan's aid militarily if Beijing looked to invade. The White House has downplayed Biden's remarks. And a part of Melbourne golf course is to be given over to the local community. Almost 6 hectares of the public course will be turned into parkland. The 9-hole course will also be redesigned, but access to the greens may be restricted to after 3 p.m. The idea to share the space teed off during COVID lockdowns.
A few days into a Labor win, they're closing golf courses. Yeah. It's a sad day for boomers. And yes. Pricey, if you're watching me, our thoughts are with you.
It's class warfare.
I actually, funnily enough, a few days ago, I was talking to a friend about how much we missed just walking around on golf courses during lockdown when you were allowed your hour exercise.
You were allowed to walk around them, but not if you were holding a golf club, correct?
Yes, that's right.
You weren't allowed.
Are there not other places to walk?
There's something about walking around a golf course. I don't know. without actually playing golf. Because I've always thought hitting the ball actually ruins your walk.
So could you just sign in to play a round of golf and just walk it? Could you do that?
You'd have to maintain distance between other golfers. You don't want to get hit in the head.
Yeah,
you don't want to walk around zigzag.
You don't want to be disturbed by people yelling out, four!
There we go.
Wow.
But you could. If we were there, enjoy it.
I think it's a very good idea.
When they ducked out of the production meeting.
Been practicing that for about 20 seconds now.
Let's head overseas again, and the Queen has surprised the crowd at the Chelsea Flower Show by turning up in a luxury golf buggy. Ahead of her Platinum Jubilee party next week, Her Majesty rode around to smell the roses. And another royal tribute has been unveiled. A special £5 coin has been minted to mark Prince William's 40th birthday next week.
It's not a luxury buggy. That looks like any other buggy.
Oh, no. It's necessary. She's got the mobility issues right now.
She's still got some energy though, hasn't she? She's getting around. She's sniffing roses. She wasn't doing that last week.
She wasn't. And as we are all brushing off our passports, a TikTok travel blogger has issued a timely warning. She says you should always opt for a pool that doesn't have a swim-up bar. The reason? Swim-up bar guests don't get out of the water.
We know,
Georgie. To use the toilet is breaking news.
Sorry, I am shocked at this.
Would you rather be in a pool where 20 to 30 people are peeing in, or would you rather go in a pool that maybe 2 to 5 people are peeing in?
What? Seriously, bugger off TikTok. This was news 30 years ago. We knew this.
Well,
why are we doing this?
You know why? Because there's a whole generation that have been locked down that don't know about the perils of wet bars in pools.
I don't think I've ever gone to a place that you can have a fancy pool bar.
Well, it's pretty standard in Bali and Thailand. And they're always, and pretty standard to a certain, I'm going to say a certain type of guy.
Yeah. Sorry, my face just went,
Well, you know, and they kind of just sit there all, do I need to explain it to you? And sometimes you're lying by the pool and you're like, you might leave to go to the bathroom, you come back, you say to the person next to you, have they moved? And the answer is always no.
Is that because they're just saving their seat?
Maybe. I don't know. I think they've just given up.
What people don't realise is we're in a pool bar right now.
Helia needs help.
No, this one doesn't even have chlorine.